The Jordan 1 to this day is still the Jordan brand shoe from 1 to 14 that came out with the most OG colorways. Michael Jordan himself didn't wear every single one of them, but there were a lot of them. And this Jordan 1 low that I'm reviewing, it is an OG colorway, but it's not the OG version of the Jordan 1 low. It's a 1985 cut. Air Jordan 1 low 85 metallic blue. Now, this shoe is dropping on March 8th for $160 in the United States. Over in Europe, this shoe already dropped in January. So if you really want this shoe, just go to like a European retailer online, one that ships overseas. Hopefully, if they have some stock, you can ship it over. And this colorway actually came back in 2016. It was the OG version of this shoe, so not an 85 cut. And we do have another 1985 cut Jordan 1 shoe coming very soon. That is the... which one was it? The dark red burgundy one, that one's coming up as well. So other metallic colorways included, so you have the blue, you had the dark red, the orange, the purple, the black, what else am I missing? And the green metallics as well. And first impressions comparing to the other metallic colorways that came out back in the day, this is right up there. I think the metallic blues are super, super nice. Let me know in the comments which metallic colorway you prefer. And the upper sole of this shoe, it is completely leather. And the leather, it's pretty good. It's pretty nice. I do prefer a leather that's like a little bit more textured. We can really see the texture come through. This one has more of that kind of shinier look to it, but it does feel nice and soft, so no big complaints there. And the swoosh, it is that metallic blue swoosh. Looks really cool. I like how that looks. Just gives it like a different dimension opposed to if it was just like a flat blue. That'll look clean as well, but this just being an OG colorway with that metallic kind of aesthetic, I like it. Now, this being an 85 cut of the Jordan 1, there's a few differences between this shoe and the Jordan 1 Low OG. So the first and probably the most obvious difference is this shoe has 8 eyelets instead of 7. The Travis Scott Low OGs, they have 8 eyelets as well, even though it's not technically an 85 cut. No idea how they choose that, but it does. Another difference is the pattern on the sole. You can see it looks slightly different. So compare this to like the powder blues. Hopefully you can see the difference. And another difference is the cushioning around the ankle collar. It's slightly more padded, slightly thicker, just ever so slightly on the 85 cut. And there's also your size printed on the ankle collar and then the product label next to it. And from a bird's eye view, the toe box area just looks slightly more rounded or slightly wider. Not the fit, just how it looks. And on the booty of the shoe, the Wings logo printed on the heel. It is not stitched or embroidered, just printed directly on that metallic blue heel. On the non-OG Jordan 1 lows, you'll see that Wings logo printed on the heel counter instead. And if you look closely, the Wings logo doesn't have the TM trademark logo on the 85 cut. That didn't exist in 1985. And another slight subtle difference is that the Nike air tag on the tongue, the swoosh on that is just ever so slightly thicker, and the font is also slightly thinner. Now, just like other Jordan 1 lows, this shoe comes with a rubber cup sole with a Nike Air unit on the heel, and then a beautiful, iconic Jordan 1 rubber outsole. And just a fun fact, this circle concentric pattern that actually began with the Nike Air Force 1s, that shoe was designed for basketball players specifically back in the day when it first came out. And this concentric pattern was meant to make it easier for players to pivot, and it made its way onto the Jordan 1s. So you can trace the origins back to the Air Force 1s, which came out in 1982. So slightly before this shoe. Now, this shoe doesn't come with any extra laces, just white laces. Pretty much looks perfect. Maybe blue or black laces would have given it a different look, but I would have just stuck with white laces. In the box of the shoe, a slim, thin Nike Jordan 1 box. Very, very nice. The shoe fits perfectly. I think they should do that for every single shoe, which just feels very snug inside. It's a lot of space savings as well. Yeah, I really like this box. It's not blue, it's red. Not sure why, but yeah, this box is great. The Nike and swoosh is also like embossed. Just feels really cool. Feels really nice. Love it. Now, in terms of sizing and comfort, I'm a wide footer. For Jordan 1 lows, if you don't have wide feet, some people can go down half a size because the padding around the ankle collar compared to the highs, it's not as much. So they feel like they have a little bit of extra wiggle room. For me as a wide footer, I've always gone true to size for OG versions of the Jordan 1 low. And for the 85 cut, I still stick true to size, even with the extra padding slightly slimmer feeling shoe. Not so much for a wide footer like myself. I think true to size is still the way to go. Now, in terms of the overall comfort, the Jordan 1's never been one of the more comfortable shoes, and it's also board lasted, so it might take a little bit extra time to break in. For casual use here and there, I wouldn't mind it at all, but if you wanted me to wear this like every single day for a whole week, there's a lot of different shoes that I would choose over this one. Rubber cup sole with a Nike Air unit on the heel, barely any technology in there. Still feels like a pretty stiff shoe that's very close to the ground. And that brings the total sole score of the Jordan 1 Low 85 Metallic Blue to 30 out of 40. Pretty good score compared to other general releases. Now, in terms of the colorway, even though it's very simple, it's very clean, there's not much to it. I think it's a very nice colorway. It's an OG colorway, which no matter how you slice it, it always does make a slight difference. It just has a bit more of a significant meaning to it, especially for someone that grew up in my generation. It's closer to that era of Michael Jordan being like the absolute god of everything. It just does mean a little bit more. Even though Michael Jordan never wore this shoe as a Chicago Bull, still, it's an OG colorway. And it's a very nice OG colorway. The metallic blue looks really nice, predominantly white sneaker. Yeah, very hard to mess this one up. Now, in terms of the materials, I think the leather is pretty nice. The tech specs, super ancient, not my favorite. It's a very old shoe and you definitely feel it. Now, in terms of the overall comfort, related to its age, the technology is barely there. There's a ton of more comfortable shoes. Even just going to the Jordan 2s, that's a very comfortable shoe. So literally the next Jordan was significantly more comfortable than this one. Casual use here and there, fine. Everyday use, wouldn't be my first pick. In terms of the versatility, no surprises here, just absolutely one of the most versatile shoes ever. You could also argue the Jordan 1 lows are maybe more versatile than highs, especially for non-sneakerheads. Most people do think it's easier to wear like low-cut shoes than high-cut shoes. And this being 90% white with that very wearable metallic blue, can't really get more versatile than this one. You can wear so many different things with this colorway, with this shoe. Honestly, the only colorway that's maybe more versatile than this one is like a black and white shoe, but all things considered, super, super wearable. The 85 cut version of the Jordan 1 doesn't come around too often, so when it does, it feels a little bit more special, and that's why Jordan brand ups the price for these, which is genius. They could easily make every single Jordan 1 low to the original specs, the original 85 specs, but they created another segment so they can upcharge us and dummies like myself, especially when it's such a nice colorway. Dummies like myself fall for it every single time. So that's it. Thanks for watching, Soul Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Air Jordan 1 Low 85 Metallic Blue. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.